معلميني وهم فأنا كانوا مع الكواليس وهم الذي بدأ الجهد في سبيل الإنجاح على المؤتمر. So I would like to take this lecture, which is actually it's a heavy lecture, but we will try to make it a little bit easy, and we will try to apply what is in the guidelines to be in the clinical practice. So all of us, we know that LDL cholesterol is a major contributor of cardiovascular risk. And you can see the higher LDL, the higher the incidence of cardiovascular event. This is coming from multiple trials in the past. Again, in the other side, if you lower the LDL, you will decrease the incidence of cardiovascular death. So when you have a patient coming to you and you want to see his dyslipidemic status, you have to ask yourself a question, which are three. How to assess the risk of this patient? And how to plan for the management of this patient and their special situation. So to assess the risk, you should ask yourself, which score system I have to do it? The second, which limit parameter I have to ask for it and target it? And then what are the risk modifier? Then if you plan for the strategy, so you should choose the goal as well as which type of drug you should start with this patient. So we will start with the first topic, which is, shall I use this exposure? And I will start with case scenario, and we will give a chance for discussion with our moderators. So this is a case, he is 45 years old, a patient. Actually, he came just for routine care because he has a typical chest pain. And he neither had diabetes or hypertension, and he is not smoking as well. At the same time, he has LDL body weight. His non-fasting total cholesterol is 220, LDL cholesterol is 130, triglyceride is 200, and he just asked how to protect himself from heart attack. All of us, we know, we need to ask about aspirin, is it good? Can I take antihypertensive? So I will open for the stage, Professor.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mohamed. Now the panelists will answer the previous interpretation. What do you do for this patient, Dr. Nasser?
For this patient, I will start to examine and I will note the nature of this chest pain. So I should subject this patient to thorough clinical examination. Then I will do the routine investigation, including chest X-ray, ECG, blah blah blah, till I reach what is the cause of chest pain. Then after that, if this patient did fasting glucose level, limit profile or no, because we have a misconception in our laboratory and our technicians. When you send some patient who is not fasting, they will return him back from the door, please fast. Actually, when we revised the data, there was no big difference between fasting and non-fasting limit, and this is message one. So for limit profile, we should refer the patient as fast as possible for the kind of lack of many reasons. And I thank Dr. Mohamed when you were operating.
Thank you very much, Dr. Aziz. Do you agree to do faster and non-faster blood limits?
Yes, as Professor Nasser mentioned, it is not indicated to be fasting for lipid profile, just only for triglyceride, which is mandatory to do fasting triglyceride limit. In this patient, who was presented by Professor Muhammad, he has this factor, really. The energy subject to be 25, GCB, even a typical GCB, limit is very high, 220, brain and total cholesterol, and triglyceride is more than 200. So that I take this oil cautiously and skin further for serious heart disease and to start management for this patient.
Okay, Dr. Khair, for these 4 points, which one you will consider for the assessment of this patient?
What should you say is 45? It's the match that was good, actually. And the 150, it's mean we have to do something. I will start the medication, actually. I have to engage this patient to a lifestyle medication. Start with exercise, diet. Now, hey, we have
Mr. Khaled, we are not going to discuss the amendment. We need the answer of this question.
One of these points. We will choose number 4, 3, 2, or 1. Number 1, Dr. Mansour Saad, and we can check. Let us provide the item.
Okay, I think age with 130, with this factor, I think we have to solve this defined.
I will explain this now. Now you are going to do risk assessment for this patient. So which one you chose? Age, cholesterol level, smoking, and blood pressure. Or age, blood sugar, smoking, and blood pressure. Or age, gender, cholesterol, blood pressure, and smoking history. This is what I was
saying. I will choose 4. I think 4 is the legit.
So here we go.
Everybody is like this one.
Okay. So regarding fasting or non-fasting, as Professor Nasser said, actually it's a fasting living profile. It's a belief of faith. It is just this is what the way that we did before. Always direct and more guidelines. Or I have to make it more perfect to do fasting. But if you look to the other side, non-fasting living profile, it is evidence-driven. You can see that 300,000 individuals were studied, and they found, as Professor Nasser said, there is no difference if you are doing fasting or non-fasting living profile. The important thing that pointed by Dr. Aziz is very important. Unless, so you can do non-fasting unless patient is diabetic and patient has high triglyceride level. So we have to recheck for fasting. So it is convenient. You can do it in the same visit. They are coming from Sada, from Hajja, and they want to go and to go back home. So it's better to do. So we agree that non-fasting lipid profile is acceptable in the other things. So let's go to which parameters you choose for lipid profile. Well, if you ask for lipid profile, what parameter you ask for?
Yes, one of you, Dr. Nasser, first, please.
Yes, lipid parameters.
Yeah, I will ask for the routine parameters. I mean the total cholesterol and LDL cholesterol, high density cholesterol. And also I will go for triglyceride and the laboratory should calculate the ratio between total cholesterol and LDL. So that will help me to make this stratification. This is answer the first.
Yes, did you agree to do with the total cholesterol number? He mentioned IMC, lipid protein, and LDL. And he mentioned also total cholesterol. Do you agree with total cholesterol?
Yes, it's the most part of the world. Total cholesterol.
Yes, which one is the more
So to go.
And the other SGN. Yes.
Okay, let's go back to our guidelines and let's see what they said. You can see that LDL cholesterol is recommended as a primary level analysis for risk stratification. And then, as mentioned by Dr. Aziz, total cholesterol is important for risk stratification, but non-HDL, it is preserved when the LDL cholesterol is low and you have patients at high risk. So you should ask for non-HDL. Actually, HDL cholesterol is not a parameter for high-risk patients or low-risk patients, because they found that treatment of HDL has no benefit, and there is a failure of therapy if you want to concentrate on HDL. So, go back to our question. Fasting LDL-5, we don't need it. And we have about regarding which one, you can see the guidelines is very clear, it's class 1 indication that asymptomatic patient more than 40 years without no cardiovascular accident, no diabetes, no familial hypercholesterolemia, and no chronic kidney disease, and no LDL more than 90, we should ask for risk score estimation that is applied by the European Society of Cardiology. So back to our patient. When we use the risk score system, the answer is yes. This is the risk score system. And you can see this risk score system is consists from age, gender, smoking, systolic blood pressure, and total cholesterol level. So this is the answer that this 5 parameters should be in our mind. So what we mean by risk score, let's mean the percentage of possibility to have cardiovascular disease death within the next 10 years. يعني خلال 10 سنوات كم البرسنتاج اللي هو ممكن يحصل لك cardiovascular disease death. Okay, so we understand this things.
Can I have this?
Yeah.
One minute, Dr. Bala. Did I not have a
moment?
High risk regions, low risk regions.
Yes.
مذكورة الدول إحنا كمان مش مذكورة في ال. We are not a member of Europe. لكن الآن قسمت إلى low risk و high risk. تدل على أيام هتكون مع low أو high risk.
Yes. Actually, I took some slides for the sake of time. There is high risk region and low risk region. So Egypt was from the low risk region. They make it from the low risk region. And when I discussed with some Egyptian in the lectures, they said we are, it's like Europe, high risk region. So in my mind, in our country, we can be at least as Egypt. So Egypt is low risk region. So the question is very important, Dr. Bai. Because this is score, there is two risk score for high risk region, the European, and for low risk region. So we consider ourselves in low risk region. Thank you, Dr. Bai.
Anyhow, I think there is many scores in the medical grounds. The famous one, the Framingham score. Then we have the Scandinavian score, but this one is very easy. Actually, it doesn't need any calculation. You can just take it and you have very high risk, and then intermediate risk, and low risk.
Yes. And remember that this risk score, as we agreed over, that this is only not for diabetes and cardiovascular. Remember this, like our patient. So let's apply this high risk. Keep it on the desk on your table in the clinic. And when the patient came, for example, our patient, another patient, so this is the five parameters. And you can find this. For example, this patient is 50 years old, okay? So his blood pressure is 160. You can keep it like this. And then he is a smoker. So it will be shifted. He's a man, so it will be shifted more. So, and he has high cholesterol, total cholesterol. So the risk, if you calculate it, you will find it is between 5 to 9%. So this patient may have cardiovascular disease. Then, in the next 10 years, the percentage is 5 to 9. It is easy. Let's go back to our patient, actually. This patient, our patient. So he is around 14, and he has normal blood pressure, and he's a man, and he's not a smoker. So it is in the gray area, okay? But his problem, that lipid profile is high. So if you calculate it, he will be in the low risk area, which is, that's mean he has less than 30% to have cardiovascular disease death. Okay, so this is for our patient. So this is the answer as chairman mentioned, that we have to ask for all these parameters if we want to risk certify this patient. So, like this patient, how should we manage? Should we go for lifestyle modification? Or Dr. Tarek, can you go ahead?
Yes, can we go for lifestyle modification alone? Or lifestyle modification plus adding drugs?
So I was Wednesday, as well as our bioassessing restart, again as it might, which is very important. Also, BCSK9 receptor progress. So, now we plan to manage. How to plan for the management? I will skip this. We will go with this case scenario again. This is a lady, she is 72 years. She came for routine follow-up. And she is not smoker, neither diabetic, not diabetic, but hypertensive. She has a history of MI 1 year ago, and she has aspirin, metoprolol, lisinopril, simvastatin 20 milligram, and her blood pressure is 140, heart rate 68, and then, as you see, associated with her face up. Dr. Faisal, please relax. LDL is 110, HDL 41, triglyceride 240, HbA1c is 6.2, and the estimated GFR is 80 million per minute. So, what next step? Can we say yes? Okay, Dr.
Yes, now for this 32 years old baby, what's the next step we can do for her?
Okay.
One of the four options. Patient is okay, no further intervention. Do you agree?
No.
No.
I don't agree with the number eight.
Number eight is logic. Elderly statin is a concern. Do you concern about the statin in this age?
I have to concern regarding EGFR, which is kind of mild degree of renal impairment, and she's an elderly lady. We should take this into consideration. But number C is no need to risk stratification. I think this is totally, we have to stratify this patient.
Yes, so that's about, we should do risk stratification, yes?
I will choose number D. And still the patient utilizes, we have fellowship for another category for this year.
فالبسباس بشكل عام من الاشياء الممتازه جدا